Hey, how's everybody doing? It's TJ with Roller Skate Universe, and of course, I'm doing another product overview. So we're just going to wait for a couple of seconds to get started. First of all, let me explain what it is that I do. When I do these product overviews, the reason I don't call them a review like a lot of other channels do is because I'm not skating on them. So this is why I call them an overview rather than a review. I'm not going to sit here and take a product that I have not skated on or I am not going to skate on and try to talk about it like I skate on it or I have skated on it. I don't do that. And that's the difference, in my opinion, between a review and an overview. If I just tell you things about the product itself without actually having used it, then that's really not a review. And a lot of other channels right now, this is what they're doing, is they say, oh, this is my review on this, but they don't actually use it. So when you see videos of me actually using the stuff, that is in fact a review. If you see me just holding up a product and talking about it, then that is an overview. So I try to have that kind of journalistic integrity, that comes along with doing that. Okay, so today we're going to talk about something that came across my bench. This is a customer build, which is a set of these Riedell 3200 boots. And I'm going to try to show you all as much as I can about them and try to give a little bit of insight. Now, right off the bat, it's really well constructed. Everything on this is single stitched right up until you get right here to the heel stay. And then the heel stay is actually triple stitched, just like the 336. It is very hard to see that, but it has almost the same exact stitch pattern that the 336 has as well. Moving around to the heel area, you really can't tell on this because he had the heels done, the sole edging done in black. So you can't really tell. But if you look in here, you can see this. Two-thirds of this heel stack right here in the middle is cork. And the reason they use cork is not only to reduce the weight, but also to increase shock absorption, which is kind of nice. I'm not going to lie about that. Now, the cool thing about these that nobody really knows is that this is based on an ice boot. And for all intents and purposes, it may as well just be that ice boot. And I don't really think a whole lot was changed except for the interior. And that was pretty much it. And that is the Model 2010 ice boot by Riedell. This is basically the same exact thing, you know, except for like interior and stuff like that. Just really, really small details. Now, they do make big differences when added up, but still, this is essentially a Model 2010 ice boot by Riedell. If you go and look that up and then you do a side-by-side comparison between the Model 2010 Riedell ice boot and the Model 3200 Riedell roller boot, you're going to have kind of a hard time at first glance really telling them apart, especially with these cutouts here and here. In fact, that's where these came from. Interior of these is, they say, a perforated suede. Honestly, it reminds me of some of the older BMW interiors. I'm kind of a car guy, or at least used to be. And of course, you know, these are little details I kind of hang on to. But it is perforated. It's micro perforated all the way in here. I really wish my lighting was just a little bit better to show this. But yes, there you go. That's a little bit better. There is a heap of generous, super generous padding in here. I mean, it is super thick, and I think you would really want this because of the upper. The upper is incredibly stiff, and I have another boot here, which is similar in build and quality, that I'm going to compare it to over here in just a second. So the upper on these is incredibly stiff. And whether or not it breaks down, it still starts off life as being really, really, really stiff. I wouldn't even know where to place that on a stiffness rating. But right here, I have a set of Harlech ice boots. And these are just as stiff, definitely just as stiff. You know, so realistically, with these 3200s, what's becoming very popular now is for skaters in the rhythm market to become very attached to using ice boots if they can get them, or something built as stiff as an ice boot, and that's fine. It's whatever. I personally couldn't do it. My knees can't take that, that torsion, that flexion. I can't do it. But yes, compared to this Harlech ice boot that I have right here, definitely just as stiff as this Harlech ice boot. And this thing's easily, you know, 10 or 15 years old, and it is still harder than a brick and still harder than a brick. Again, I don't know if these break down over time and kind of become a little bit more generous, but I, you know, with the flex, I hope so. I really do. Now, Color Lab is completely free on these. Let me kind of delve into that a little bit. A lot of times when you see people with the model 951, they say, oh, it's a Color Lab 951. Well, here's the thing. It's very redundant because on these and the Color Labs are, sorry, the 951s, Color Lab is absolutely free on that. So if somebody says, I got a Color Lab 3200, you just got a, you know, 3200 or whatever. The 951s, the Color Lab is completely inclusive. So it's a little bit redundant on the 951. Just because there is no stock color on a 951. All right. Anyways, tongue on this is pretty thick. I'm not going to say antic thick, which I have a set of the original AR, some of the original AR1s here. It's almost as thick as this one, you know. But of course, different construction. And of course, we're bringing back that micro perforated micro suede. To me, it's almost like a leatherette. Interior. I really would love to know how the ventilation works on this. I hope, personally, I really hope that that it works really well for the user. That'd be awesome. I would love that. And of course, custom widths and stuff like that, depending on what they are available. These are, and here we go, for all my wide-footed folks, check this out. These are a 10-2E, or if you go in here, these are made 10-EE. This is what the customer wanted. These are a double E width. He's got a very wide foot, very, very wide, very wide foot, you know, and these are options that are available on these that people don't talk about. You know, a lot of times when people go to order these skaters go to order these boots, they say, you know, I can't get that. It's too narrow for me, or I can't get that. It's too wide for me. And a lot of the times this stuff's available in custom widths, especially when you're dealing with Riedell. You know, one thing that I learned is that the 120s that we talked about last time, the Riedell model 120s are actually available in like three different widths. You can get them in narrow, medium, wide, all the way out, which is really cool. So let's next talk about the weight. I'm gonna be completely honest with y'all. These things are tanks, man. So I'm gonna try to get my handy dandy shipping scale involved here, and we're going to go ahead and get the weight on these things. All right, so I like to weigh things in grams. I weigh pretty much every skate part in grams. I don't know why, I just do. People on the other side of the pond really love that. Me personally, I feel like it's a great unit of measurement for weight. Now these things are friggin' bricks. Check this out though. We're on grams, we're at zero. All right, let's see if I can get this. All right, there we go. Cool, here we go. You see this? Check this out. 974 grams. And just to confirm that we are seeing this the right way, we're going to do this three times. I will zero this thing out every time. Second time, 974. Okay, zero this out again. Boom. 974. That is almost 1,000 grams just for the boot. These things are heavy. You know, again, this is a size 10 double E. It's whatever. I really like them, though. I really do. The shape up here throws me off. It really does. I do like this. They have, let me get this out of the way. Let me get the laces out of the way here. And I'm going to tuck this back in here. But right here, we got a flex notch. I really like that. Although with a boot this stiff, I don't know how long it's going to take someone to break this in to be able to make this flex notch even usable, but I guess it's there for whatever. Most of the skaters that are using these things aren't even tying them up past this flex notch anyways. In fact, a lot of them are just doing this stuff here, which is, it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't functionally do anything. In fact, it's like really bad for your Achilles tendon. And it's even worse for the boot. I don't know. Pretty cool though. It's about $700. It's an interesting piece. You know, I maybe one day venture on trying to try one out, but I already know that it's not going to do my knees or my back a lot of favors. So comparatively, this with the 336, this is like a 336 on steroids that just decided to get absolutely shredded in the gym, you know, and me personally, I would actually prefer a 336 with this interior. If I had to choose, I would just rather just get a custom 336 with this interior as opposed to just buying this, because this just seems like too much for 9/10 of the skaters that are going to buy it. This is almost too much skate, really, especially with the weight. I can't honestly tell you what attributes to being almost an entire kilogram for one boot, but I can tell you it's overbuilt. It's definitely one of those boots that you can tell is going to be one of those 20, 30 year or even 40 year boots. Like, these are going to be the ones that, like, you can hand these down to your grandkids and they're probably going to look just as nice as the day you got them, you know, which is saying a lot. It's actually pretty impressive. I like it a lot. You know, maybe eventually I'll get to skate one, but I really hope you enjoyed the overview. Again, this is not a review because I am not skating it. I know a lot of other channels, they sit there and they hold a product up and they talk about it, but you never see them skate on it. And then they call it a review. That's what makes this different. That's what makes this an overview, because I'm showing it to you and I'm not skating on it. So I'm not going to lie to you and call it a review. It's not a review. So, this is the Riedell 3200. I really thought it's really well made. It really, really is. Honestly, it gives, you know, it gives this Harlech a run for its money as far as build quality. It really does. It's put together so nicely. It's worth almost $700. Yes. Will it make you a better skater? Maybe not. Unless there's some sort of weird mobility hack that you're looking for out of it. I'm going to be honest with you. You cannot buy skill. More expensive setups, they're not going to make you a better skater. It doesn't work like that. There are a lot of skaters that are what I like to call catalog skaters or bench skaters. And what they'll do is they'll come to their local pro shop of any sort, whether it's attached to a rink or not. And what they'll do is they'll come to their local skate shop or pro shop at a rink. And then what they'll do is they'll open up the catalog and they'll look at the most expensive stuff, or they'll even outright ask, like, what's the most expensive thing you have? And what they'll do next is they'll say, I want this, 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 this. They'll go right down the menu and they'll order all the most expensive stuff. And a lot of these skaters haven't even been skating a year. And what they think they're going to do is they're going to buy it and it's going to instantly transform how they skate. Or what's going to happen next is they're going to buy it and they're going to grow into it as far as skill, you know. And unfortunately, it doesn't work like that. There are a lot of skaters that can take, and they don't really get talked about a whole lot, but there are a lot of skaters that could take something that is pretty much, destined to be thrown in a dumpster, and they can throw it on and they can make it work, and they can do things on it that most people can't do in a setup like this. That's not to talk down on the people who are buying these products. Please, please, please do not take it like that. I know this is 2021. I know it's really easy for people to do that. And I'm going to tell you right now, that's where this train stops. Don't do that with me. No, you cannot buy skill. Buying the most expensive thing in the catalog is not going to make you better. It is not. There is only one thing that makes skaters any good when it comes to skating. Time. Seriously, time. And I'm not talking about time jumping around all the Facebook groups or on Reddit or, watching videos. That's not going to do much. We're talking about actual seat time. We're talking about skates on the feet time. The less of that you have, the less impact everything else is going to have. That's just how it works. I know that right now there are a lot of people that might not like to hear that, but that's God honest truth. 400 selfies on Instagram are not going to make up for 2 hours of practice in the real world on skates. So I hope you like the overview. It's really a nice boot. I think a few things were misworded in the catalog, something about shuffle skating and stuff like that. And I'm like, well, we're shuffle skating on stuff like this. We've been shuffle skating on stuff like this for 30, 40 years. Like, you don't need a high top boot to shuffle skate. And the other thing is, like, nowadays you see people like talking about jam skating and they're running stuff like this. And I'm like, no, we've been jam skating on stuff like this for 34 years. Jam skating incorporates breakdancing, or at least something close to breakdancing. It's not cute dresses. It's not high top boots. It's not, looking a certain way. It's not any of that stuff. I've been doing the stuff since the mid-90s. I competed nationally for it since the early 2000s, and I still compete in it. And I can tell you what real is. A lot of what's going on right now, about 95% of what's out there right now, getting called in the hashtag jam skating, ain't the real thing. It is not. I can prove that much. That's easy. And, I got no problem saying that. But anyways, they're talking about something about shuffle skating, and I'm like, dude, shuffle skate in anything. I don't know why you have to have this boot to shuffle skate in. I don't know. Somebody make this make sense. But hope you enjoyed, and if you like what you see, like, share, subscribe. Check a set of these out if you can. If you know somebody in your area, just ask them to kind of, feel them and stuff like that. Or, if they're really nice, maybe they might let you skate on them. I don't know. But I always advise skaters get to try something on, even if your buddy can't let you skate on them. See if somebody will let you try them on if they're a close size to you. Also, shoe size is not skate size. Cut that crap out. Seriously, just because you wear a 13 does not mean you fit a 13. Or just because a 13 fits on you does not mean you fit a 13. Quit it. Seriously. If you're like friggin', 5'10" and you're on a 13, you're skating around looking like the letter L. That does not work. Longer boot equals longer plate. Longer plate that's already too long for your foot, it's not like skating anymore. It's going to be like skiing. Cut it out. Seriously. Go to a skate shop with a competent person working there and have them size your freaking foot. And if it says you're a 9.5, you are a 9.5. Let it go. Let the dream die. Hey, they're skates, okay? They need to fit like skates. If I hear, every time I see somebody say, yeah, I wear a size 13 street shoe. Yeah, well, guess what? That doesn't mean you fit it. And I'm going to say, at the very minimum, I'm going to say, take your insole out. And I'm going to look at where the toe is on the insole. And if there's like a dead space between the end of your big toe and that insole, that tells me you're lying. You need to have these fit your foot as closely as possible, whether you like it or not. You're going to need to. Because roller skating involves things that being on shoes doesn't. Movements and things like that, and lateral shifting that you don't do on normal shoes. And they're reliant on those forces. So when you do that, you introduce sliding and everything else. And you may not get blisters in your size 15.5, Nikes or whatever it is you wear, just because you're walking around, that's nothing. But as soon as you put on a pair of skates in the same size and you start turning and shifting your weight inside and back and forth inside of that boot, you're going to get shredded like lettuce, and it's going to hurt, and then you're going to be wondering why. And especially if you spent your own money on this stuff. So go to a competent pro shop, an actual registered authorized dealer, and get your feet sized. And whatever it says is correct. Don't be like, oh, well, yeah, it says I'm a 9.5, but I wear a 13, so let me get an 11. No, get the 9.5, and at worst, at very most, just go up a half a size. That's all. Hope you enjoyed it. Sorry for all the, the fakes and stuff like that. But, hey, what are you going to do? I'm just trying to stay out here, and keep you guys informed. Happy skating, everyone. Peace.